Hello, everyone. How are you doing tonight? My name is WonderGoon. Welcome to the stream. We're doing a little something different tonight. Kesedrith is not here with us tonight, so he is for the Easter weekend. He is visiting his family. So I'm on my own for the night. This is not an episode of the Midnight Stream to Nowhere, though it is in the same time slot as the Midnight Stream to Nowhere. We're going to be playing a new game tonight. It's called Glitchhikers, The Spaces Between, and it is a game that is deals with introspection and mental health issues. And I will not be using a camera tonight. There's not going to be much, if any. In fact, I don't think there's any overlay. It's just the base game. Or the base game. It's just the game that you will be seeing. So let me get it started up here. We will talk about it more in depth as we go. So here is... There we go. I wanted to show all of the opening media and so forth and who is behind it. It is a Canadian game. It's available on all major platforms that you get games. Now, this game, as I said, does deal with mental health issues. In the options, under content here, you can see that it does offer mental health resources. Takethis.org/resources. You can change filters at any time. Current journey will not be affected. You are encouraged to revisit these settings at your journey through as your journey through life progresses. There are different filters dealing with death and grief, suicide and nihilism, abuse, substance abuse, and body horror, though I don't know what they mean by body horror. And then there's some save information. Now, I do not know exactly what they consider any of these for this playthrough. I'm going to have them all off. For a playthrough I do on, you know, off stream, I will probably turn a couple of these on. But that's not going to happen tonight. As I said, this game does deal with mental health issues. It is designed to be a game that explores you as you play it, and so that's what we are going to do. I'm going to do my honest level best to answer the questions as honestly as I can, as if I am the person going through this adventure, you know, in real life. So that's the situation, that's what it's all about, and let's get started. Now, I did look at this a little earlier to make sure everything would look okay on stream and so forth, but I'm going to go back through. It's a little stop for in between on the journeys of life, right? It's kind of a surreal thing. I don't know how well you guys can hear the music. I turned it kind of down, but I'll turn it back up. So you guys can hear the music a little bit better. There we go. Hopefully that's not too terribly loud. If that's too loud, please let me know. Most people come here between journeys, whether those journeys are physical, mental, spiritual, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Tonight you can head out to the highway if you'd like, or you could head to the nearby railway and hop aboard a commuter train. Late night driving is kind of chill. I really like it. This is what attracted me to this game, is that it's atmospheric and it's introspective. I enjoy an introspective experience when dealing with life's issues. Kind of one of the reasons why I don't have a camera tonight, because I don't know how I'm going to respond to what happens here. And if I start to ugly cry on screen, I don't want you guys to see that. So there's never a right or wrong answer out here. It's an interesting game so far. If you want more information about the game itself, !glitch. Kind of a trippy thing, right? Basically comes back to the same. Tyrannian. Hey, bud. What's going on, man? Thank you. Thank you for the raid. I'm not using a camera tonight as I explore this new game. So welcome everyone in. This game is called Glitchhikers, the exploring, or the spaces between, and I'm not using a camera tonight. not playing WoW is kind of weird to me. Well, Cybernight, first of all, thank you for being here. And second, I just needed to get away from that for a little bit. Normally, I have a podcast tonight where I talk about various topics and whatnot. And it's a lot of introspection and so forth in a lot of our conversations. So that's what we're doing here tonight. Like I said, this game is called Glitchhikers, The Spaces Between. Yeah, exactly, Tyrannian. You need to just unwind with something new. Think about these things. And we're on a journey. We're exploring the spaces between. And we're going to go for a ride. We're going to learn a little something about ourselves, or at least I am. And this is the kind of game and the kind of activity that I like to engage in sometimes. Thought experiments about who I am, what my values are, how I feel about certain things, how I want to interact with the world, what are my limits, etc., that sort of thing. And this game seems to have all of that built into it, and so that's what we're doing. And it's open your mind and settle into the experience. That's it. The aesthetics of this are really great. There is some music. I don't know if you guys can hear it very well. If there's any problems with the sound, if it's too loud, too low, please let me know. I will adjust things as best I can. And welcome to the stream. I hope you enjoy the game. And if you have any questions, please let me know. !glitch. If you want to learn a little bit more about the game itself, it'll bring up a link to their the company's website. You can see the launch trailer. You can learn a little bit more about the game. There you go. Thank you, Tyrannian. That link has all the information you need. And he's talking about if you need resources outside of the experience, a link is available in the pause menu as well. And I'll show you that here. What they're talking about is you can have any kind of content, stuff that is personal to you, right? Mental health resources, takethis.org/resources. You can change filters in the game so you deal with death or grief if you have that in your life. Suicide, nihilism, abuse, substance abuse, or body horror. I'm not sure what they mean by body horror, but we'll get to that. So you could turn these filters on and off as to what you want to deal with in the game. I've got them all off for the initial playthrough here, but we will see what else can be seen. So sure how to there we go. Okay. Sort of drink. Backspace. All the keys are like spread out over the keyboard. Backspace, that sort of thing. Okay. All right, let's get on with it. Let's hope it does, right? Out on the highway, the train, or the... I like driving. Let's just start the journey, yeah? I hope I don't have to actually control the car, because I'm terrible at driving games. Another reason why I have my camera off, so I don't have to have the lights on, and so I can kind of, oh shit.
Good evening, and welcome to Radio 90 Night Drive. Thanks for tuning in. The story goes that early film viewers panicked at the sight of a train rushing towards them. On the web, we navigate spaces shaped by information and data. In video games, we will our avatar bodies to weave around obstacles, and in VR, our stomachs turn at the edge of a digital cliff. We immerse ourselves in a reality on a screen, a reality that is no less real than any other. Realities within realities that sometimes tell us more about our own reality than what we think is real. And what we think is real is telling. What will your brain tell you as you drive the dark roads of reality? What truths are rushing towards you? And when the spectacle gets all too real, will you panic like the apocryphal film viewers, or drive on? With our next song, Find Me on a Whim.
Oh, that's kind of nice, isn't it? What do these signs say? I have no idea. I'll get over and give that guy some space. I don't know if I should have turned, What? Oh. Where'd this kid come from? Is that a joint? I was on Steam, and it ran across it on Steam. Yeah, I found it on Steam and just decided it was on sale at the time. I don't think it's on sale anymore, but yeah. It looked interesting. I think I bought it for like $4 or something. Huh. Okay. Yeah, right?
The future may stretch before us, but the past is finite.
That's true.
13.77 billion years since the universe was created. Over 5 trillion days. When we can't truly comprehend that number, is that really finite? Can meaning be found? Or are we destined to drive onward in bafflement, lost as a speck of time about to blink out?
Don't blink, driver.
Jellyfission is up next.
It's kind of got a chill vibe to it, that's for sure. I wonder if whatever lane you're in makes a difference, like for what you encounter. I don't know. When you drive at night like this, if you drive at night like this, do you think about things that, I mean, about the life that you have, the people you know, the choices you've made? Hello? I think I'm usually jamming some tunes to stay awake. The universe is expanding, and yet the universe has no edge. What is it expanding into? I'm in my fourth year of physics, and even I don't really get it. Infinite universe with infinite universes within it. Each of us our own little infinity. That's kind of a nice thought, isn't it? When I was younger, before I became more of a cynic as far as religion is concerned, I had a philosophy that I followed that I created myself, and it was I called it infinite self-discovery. And the logic behind it was that is exactly this. We are our own infinity, right? And the more you learn about yourself, the more you can learn about yourself, because you are changing constantly. When you learn something new, you have grown and expanded who you are, who your sense of self, your identity. And so when you got a new philosophy, you got a new piece of information, and you put it into your cognitive reasoning, you grew as a person, right? And so the whole philosophy was all about infinitely discovering who you are and continued infinite growth. This statement, each of us our own little infinity, reflects that. It's kind of neat to see it in there. That's true. We're just one little planet in a otherwise unremarkable galaxy. In our local group, I mean, there's nothing really truly remarkable about the Milky Way. Even within an infinity of the unknown, we still have love and happiness and life. And really, isn't that all we really need, right? We have the love of a good partner or family or friends. We have happiness, so that brings a sense of happiness, right? We have a sense of happiness about our accomplishments in our professional lives, and our accomplishments in our personal lives. And we have life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. It's kind of encoded in those founding documents of our own country, but it goes way deeper than nationalism. It is a sense of who we are, right? I mean, does that make sense to anybody else? And and all the crazy infinity that is our existence and all the vastness of understanding we still lack, there's this amazing thing that is consciousness. Carl Sagan once said that since we are part of the universe, consciousness allows the universe to know itself. That's beautiful. And I agree with Dr. Sagan, yes. Doing chemistry experiments, right? Just a simple grade school exercise of burning different substances to see the colors they produce, like fireworks, magnesium, copper, strontium, lithium. Science and art come together. Yeah, it's different colors, or different chemicals have different colors when they burn. It's such an amazing universe we live in. Her energy and enthusiasm were so beautiful. We talked about different kinds of stars and the heat death of the universe and the nature of entropy. It was the start of something wonderful. We went away the next day, far away to a little world of our own, floating amongst nebulae and white dwarfs and undiscovered planets. Her sense of humor was dry. Sometimes I didn't even know if she was joking. She said the most absurd things, how she wanted to die in the heart of a star. I said she'd burn up long before she got close, and she looked at me like it was a challenge. We laughed and cried together, helped each other through tough times, family and friends in our own minds. The way she looked at me, a little smile in her eyes, the way she could rattle off chemical equations and the constructions of molecules. She drew them in her sleep, and I'd watch her eyelids flutter gently, the rise and fall of her chest, the tendons in her arms. I wonder if I can look at her while I'm... I don't appear to be in any danger of running into anything. Okay, I can look temporarily, apparently. Love that burns as bright and burns hot burns the shortest, right? That's true. Everything we go through doesn't mean a lick of shit in the end, because 5 billion years from now, the sun will expand and this planet will die. And everything on it, all of our history, all of who we are, will be gone. Unless we manage to leave the planet somehow. And it is a wonderful thing to be a part of in the meantime. We are part of this 1 second of the universe's life where there will be light. Everything, once all the light dies, there'll be endless darkness. Okay.
You are you, but who you are changes with time, with context.
Yeah.
What mask do you put on around others? Strangers, friends, family, lovers? Do you ever take it off? Can you? Is there a you that is you? A 3-pound sack of tissue and nerves pilots a vehicle of meat and bone. Bursts of electricity instruct your foot to press on the gas, your hands to hold the wheel, your heart to beat, your eyes to blink. Did you blink? Did you remember to breathe? Remember to listen now.
With our next song, 13 Black Cats.
Okay, I need to buy the soundtrack to this, because this is a really great, really great soundtrack. And masks, oh God, we can talk about masks all night. What an amazing topic masks are, right? We wear masks every day. We start a stream, we're wearing a mask. We're presenting an outside face to our viewers, right? Yeah, isn't it though? I'm so glad I bought this. But we do wear masks, don't we? We wear masks every day. The face I show to my wife is different than the face I show to my mother, which is all different to the face that I show to you, my viewers, and to my other friends, right? We're all made up of masks. There is a sense of losing yourself in a way to that, don't you think? And we're about to pick somebody else up, it looks like. Let's see who joins us on this journey. Isn't that the greater thing? I'm just gonna say, don't you know? Oh, that's a great point. Maps are so awesome. I love maps. Oh, what a great question. What are you showing, but what are you not showing? And it goes back to the masks. What are you not showing, right? What are you not revealing to the world when you put on that mask in the morning or afternoon or whatever? I think I just drove off the road. It's just that it's such a great point. What are you not showing? That's true too. Our flat maps are not entirely accurate. True. Africa is much larger than people think it is. And that's exactly what, since European map makers made the maps that most people use, I do think about things like that. It's like he was saying, you know, European map makers made those maps, so everything was Eurocentric, but Africa is so much better. If imagine the world's history if African explorers replaced European explorers, how large Africa would be, right? It's just, you know, how different the world history will be. True enough. It's a complex world, complex universe. You tug on the mosaic of one thing, the thread of the mosaic in one place, and something else elsewhere moves, right? It's connected, and it's way more complex than we give, you know, much credence to or thought of. It is. Psychogeography. I'll have to remember to look that up. God, what an interesting thought. And when you think about it, it's kind of elemental, right? It's kind of obvious that connectivity is obvious, but we never really think about it. If you look at a highway system map of just the United States, or just the state that you live in, and or wherever it is that you live in the world, and you see how the communities are all connected through the arteries of the highway system, right? The roads. And if we never invented roads, where would we be, right? That's true. Globalization is good, but it's also can be bad as well. Exactly. We lose sight of the fact that one size doesn't fit all. What a key concept to remember. Nothing works for everyone. Everyone's an individual and deserves their own solution. Can't just throw money at something from afar. You can't just impose your own ideas of what works and what doesn't. There's never a simple answer. It's always more complicated. Yes. Yes. And that applies to everything that you will face in life. Indeed. Okay. Well, thank you for that visit. Appreciate it. I'm going to change lanes while I have the opportunity.
How well can we truly know one another? We're surrounded by each other every day. We see. We speak. We listen. We love. We teach. We touch. But we can never know. We can never experience the world exactly how someone else does. We can never be inside their head. But tonight, we're all on this journey together. We're all in your head. Head onwards, driver.
Comrade 618 is up next.
Bass crew with creepy synths. When you drive, do you change lanes a lot? I tend to stay in this lane, the slow lane. It's just the way I prefer to do things. I don't like switching lanes a lot. The only reason I'm switching lanes in this is because it's a game, right? There's, you know, doesn't appear to have any real reason for it, but and I'm not in a hurry to get wherever I'm going, right? This, I guess that's part of the attraction of this. But to the point, yeah, that interconnectivity is also kind of limiting in a way. Because, again, going back to the masks, how well do we know each other? How well do we present our thoughts and feelings to the world, right? Does that make sense? Am I just talking out the other side? What do you guys think? Gaussian bluffs. Got our next visitor coming up. There they are. Let's see what they have to say. Boom, boom. Alas, poor Yorick. Who has a CRT screen anymore? The good, the bad, not when I'm so attached to it, of course. We all are, if not so literally. People have such polarized views on technology. Don't give up any of your privacy or let it into every aspect of your life. It's a natural part of how we move through life, or it's inscrutable and unnecessary. It's ruining the world, or it'll save the world. Oh, that's a good question too, right? It does improve our lives. I can see the other side about not being having it, but I also feel this is true. Theoretically, yes, we should be able to decide its future. It's so easy to misstep with technology, after all. It's as fallible as its creators, and its creators are often very fallible. True enough. Algorithms are designed by people, and people aren't often ignorant of their biases or seduced by profit. True enough. I think I said aren't often, or they are often ignorant of their biases. Biases just creep into everything, don't they? You have to be really careful about how you look at things and how you react to things. Yeah. True enough, you need some technology in your life, right? I mean, I'm a streamer saying you need technology in your life. I'm streaming on Twitch. You guys are watching this. Presumably, there's people watching it. So, you need that technology. I kind of depend on it. We all depend on it if you have a cell phone, especially. This is true. Technology is a fascinating tool. It's, you know, it's a better computer, it's a better phone, it's a better, more efficient fuel economy for your vehicle, for transportation. But it needs to be tempered. To think I'm a we're gonna get into a little bit of area where people may have strong opinions. This is gonna bring out a lot of strong opinions, but I agree with that. I agree with this too. We've lost all nuance with things. Nothing is ever black and white in this world. Nothing. It's all shades of gray. Everything is shades of gray. And it's, what a line. We're inundated with myths. Absolutely. True enough. Again, that's that nuance. Hey, Classic, it's going pretty well, man. I'm playing this really interesting game. I think you'd like this game. They say video games make people violent. Simply untrue. Research has found video games have no significant impact on violent behavior and can even promote empathy. There's the idea that the solution to technology is more technology. Very real innovation that can help mitigate climate change. There are a host of Cash grab scams. Those robot boats that are going to clean all the world's rivers, they don't mention anything about microbeads. This is what I'm talking about. I mean, it's the nuance thing, right? It's all about going beyond, right? Engagement demands outrage and absolute. Okay. I agree with this. People do not think critically enough. Exactly. Exactly. A skill that we should be taught more and earlier in life. If you cannot critically think, if you just accept what is just shoveled down your gullet and without thinking about it, you are doing yourself the greatest disservice you could ever do to yourself. Classy Daddy, it's going well. If you have never seen this game before, it's called Glitchhikers, The Spaces Between. It's all about self-exploration and finding out who you are. You want to know more about it? !glitch. And that will tell you about it. You can see some of the gameplay and read about it a little bit on their website and so forth. I ran across it on Steam and thought I'd do a little stream of it and have some fun with it. So, no matter what else, you have to take it all seriously. Social media is the new town square. Extra, read all about it. Cryptocurrency is killing the planet. Facial recognition can and will profile us as much as any cop. Absolutely 100% true. Okay, cryptocurrency is but the facial recognition is very, very dangerous because they can just say, well, this guy looks like the person that this person described, so there you go, you got a murder charge or whatever, right? It can be abused, all right? Now, not all organizations are going to abuse it, but the possibility of abuse is just too... It's too much. There needs to be some brakes on it. There need to be some checks on it. That's all I'm saying. Cryptocurrency thing is legit. NPR did a piece on it. I don't know about that, man. But then again, I'll be first one to tell you I don't have a lot of knowledge when it comes to cryptocurrencies. That's the question, isn't it? See, I just don't know, Classic. I just don't know if I agree with that or not. I mean, I don't know much about it. Can you get me the link to that piece? Either put it in the Discord or DM it to me on Discord, whichever one. Well, that's true. It's there. It's I do enjoy driving. I just wish I could do it more. Especially late night drives, you know, through the desert like this. Look at this landscape. it is kind of a and it sounds kind of stupid when I say it that way, you know, or it's phrased this way. It's a journey of the soul. I don't know that there's necessarily a soul, but it is. Driving is when I, especially at night like this, is when I get my best ideas for books. That's where I get my best ideas for role-playing games. That's where I get my best ideas for concepts of streams. That's where I came up with the Midnight Stream to Nowhere when I was driving one night. And I was like, oh, this will be fun, you know? So, driving is a spiritual thing. Not necessarily, but I do enjoy doing it. I do enjoy the time to think. And that's the big thing for me, is thinking and bringing all of this together. Well, it obviously helps. And they're out. Okay. So here's the issue. Farming Bitcoin takes a lot of power on an industrial scale, so these farms are set up in areas with cheap power. Okay. Usually means buying land in an area with an underused power plant and setting up servers and trailers to take advantage of excess power capacity. There's almost always near a coal burning plant. Alright. This whole, look at this setup here. You have three lanes. Do you prefer the quote-unquote fast lane? Now, in the United States, this lane is considered the fast lane, right? This is sort of the middle of the road lane, and this is considered the slow lane. Which lane do you drive in? I like the slow lane, because where I'm going, and unless I'm just in a hurry, I still drive in the slow lane. Driving on this side of the road generally has advantages that I like.
The road stretches before us all, whether we drive it or not. Where does it lead you? Do you have a destination in mind, or is the future a mystery? Does that ribbon of highway disappear in darkness, or is there a light that guides you? Is life taking you on a journey, or do you set your own path? We all have a path to follow or forge. It intersects with others. Stoplights, and mergers, and exits. Sometimes, it stretches for miles, alone.
Oh, that's the best.
But we're not alone, are we, driver? No matter what we might tell ourselves. Clear your mind and count down with me, driver. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back. This has been Radio 90 Night Drive. Be well. Good night.
You like the center lane? See, I like the right lane because if I have car trouble, I can get over to the right, right? Most lanes on the highway that I need to go to the right, right? So you've got one hand on the button. You've got one hand. All right. On the wheel. There's a tension as you hover. Uncertain. I think that was the point that they were making, is that cryptocurrency is bad for the environment because it requires more power and coal. Oh, I had a choice there. Do you see that? And I didn't even really pay much attention to it. I guess that was the game. That's a short little game. I guess you could take different... You had different choices. You could take the train, you could take a plane, and then you could take the car to drive. So... I'm just going to let the credits play. Yeah, probably so, Classic. I would think so. I want to give this company some, you know, some, not that my channel reaches 1,000 people a night, right? But I want to, this is a fun game. I enjoyed this. Again, you can get this on Steam, you can get it on Nintendo Switch, you can get it on GOG, you can get it on itch.io, or itch.io, I think is how you pronounce it. You can get it on various other platforms. I got my copy on Steam. It was just a fun game. I enjoyed this. Please support these companies, and please support this game. Please go buy this game. You can buy it on Steam for I think it's $12.99 right now. And if you want more information about it, !glitch. What a great game. I am well impressed with this game. You can go back to it and do another one if you wanted to. Now there's a path. There's the highway, which we just did. There's infinite drive, which I guess is just driving, so we could talk and that sort of thing. Oh, Classic, since you came in late, let me show you this. Under the options menu here, you have some content choices. You can change the filters. You could deal with death and grief, suicide and nihilism, abuse, substance abuse, and body horror. And all of these are off for this stream. But there's resources here. If you are dealing with any of these issues, please get help. Talk to somebody, please. It's there for you to, so... Yeah, exactly, right? And in a video game, people don't think about that, so... And this is a little shop. You can talk to the clerk and ask questions or whatever. I'm really impressed by this game. I really enjoy it. This is a lot of fun. And you may be wondering why I don't have a camera on. The reason is because I wanted to give the game center stage, right? You don't need to look at my face with it, because this is very heavy topics. to deal with, and it's the thoughts of, you know, going through life and making how sure things work or whatever, and your views and stuff. You don't need my face there to distract you from that, right? It's meant to be you in the game, right? So that's another reason why I don't have a camera on, because I wanted to be involved. I wanted to be immersed in this whole thing. So I have my lights off, and dark cameras, dark screens on a webcam aren't very posh, I guess, for a stream. All right, so that's going to do it, I think. I think I'm going to hang it up now. God, I just want to thank everyone for being here. I hope you all enjoyed it. Classic Daddy, thank you for that, for joining in. I want to thank Cyber Knight for being here. I want to thank Tyrannian for being here. Thank you, Tyrannian, for the huge rate of 7 people. I do appreciate you so much. Thank you. The game is called Glitchhikers, The Spaces Between. You can get it on Steam or GOG.com or any of the other platforms. Please support this company. It's a great game. It's a lot of fun. I had a blast playing this, and I will play it a lot, I believe, over the next bit of time. So thank you all for being here. You guys are awesome. Thank you. I'm going to say goodbye. And my next stream will be Monday night, 6 p.m. for more World of Warcraft action. We're going to be playing some, probably going to do some She-Zombie action, though that's unless I can maybe talk Classic or Kessadrith if he's back from his trip on Monday to do some SOM leveling or what have you. Oh, Classic Daddy, thank you. I will. And JoJo, is my pleasure. I hope it was enjoyable for everyone. I will stream this again at some point. Maybe we can do, I'll work out where I want to put it in the schedule. okay, I mean, twist my arm, LOL. Oh, by the way, Classic, I sent you some stuff in the mail to your character on Shadow Strike, Salty Fanny. All right, y'all, good night. Have a great night. Please be safe. Be kind to each other and be kind to yourselves. And we'll see you Monday at 6 p.m.